Hello YouTube, Kaitlyn here, and you had some questions for me, and I am going to answer them. Let's do this! There's a bobby pin in my hair. This is the problem with having a whole lot of hair. You just end up with bobby pins just randomly stuck in it. I don't know which one to start with, they're all so good. Total Runtime asks, on average, how long does it take to make a video? From concept to shooting to editing to uploading. It depends on how much work I want to put into it. When I did Veda last year, I was kind of able to refine it down to one day, so anywhere between 4 and 8 hours. But for my normal videos, I kind of spread it out over time. I tend to write a bunch of scripts at once and then film a bunch of videos over a few days, and then I will kind of start editing on the Monday before the video goes out on Thursday and, you know, edit a little bit each day. Essentially, there's always a part of me that's thinking about YouTube. I think that's the only way I'm able to balance all of my things, my real life and my YouTube videos. So I'm like at work or hanging out with friends and suddenly I come up with a concept for a video and I'm mentally writing it in my head while also doing what else I'm supposed to be doing. For the actual video though, if I put as much time and effort and like graphics into it that I want to, it probably takes about 4 hours. And then uploading is a little bit longer because I have to write all the descriptions and tags and make a thumbnail, and I've been doing captions for the last few months, so that also probably takes a good 30 to 40 minutes of just sitting down and writing out whatever I'm saying in the video. She wants to know, do you have any advice for people with social anxiety starting school soon? Sort of. I both loved and loathed the start of school every year. Whenever I started a new school, like going into middle school or high school, I was a total wreck. Because you're going to be in a new environment with a lot of new people, and there are all kinds of new expectations that you don't understand quite yet. But even if you're not starting in a new school, there's still this fear of going into an environment and starting over and wanting to impress people, and it just can be kind of overtaking. So if we're going for advice, I guess I could say, don't care what people think. I mean, that doesn't really work. Like, that's what I have to tell myself whenever I do something like going back to school or going into a new environment. I don't always believe it, but if I just keep repeating it in my head, it does help a little bit. Also, going in just assuming that people are going to like you, I think really helps. Just having this false confidence, basically, like building yourself up to a point where you're like, everyone's going to like me because I'm really awesome, and just going in with your head held high, I think is also very helpful. You kind of fool yourself out of some of your social anxiety. Autumn Rain wants to know, what kind of music do you like and who's your favorite artist? You seem like you'd like stuff like Gotta Have You by The Weepies and Flightless Bird American Mouth by Iron and Wine. You are right by Flightless Bird American Mouth and Iron and Wine. Actually, my favorite song right now is by Iron and Wine. It is Such Great Heights, which is actually a Postal Service song, but I really like Iron and Wine's There's a hummingbird outside. Ooh. Iron and Wine has a really cool folky acoustic version sounding of the song. I'm gonna link it over here because it's really great and I love it and you should listen to it. And as for music and artists as a whole, I kind of like a lot of things. I would say my most favorite stuff comes in the more indie and folk sounding things, even maybe some electronic stuff. Bands like Death Cab for Cutie and the Postal Service and Snow Patrol, Coldplay, all that kind of cool stuff. Mad as a Hatter, and that is a very cool name, says, what is your passion here on YouTube or the reason you created your channel? So my story on why I started YouTube might be worth a whole video, but I'll give you kind of a basic rundown. I really started making YouTube videos because I was in a film program, and even though I was in a film program, there were very few opportunities to make films, unfortunately. And when I started watching YouTubers, I saw that they were just making things and they had this audience to look at it and to critique it, and I was like, I want this. Essentially, I was inspired by other people creating and learning from that creation, and I just wanted to experiment too. But then I kind of had to come up with a purpose behind my channel, and in thinking about that, that's where I realized that I really wanted to be the role model that I needed when I was a teen. It gave me this feeling of giving back to the world in hopes hopefully making life easier for some people. Things that I really would have wanted and needed to know when I was a teen or just starting in college. Does that make any sense? All right, this is the last question for this video because I am going to be late for work. But Amanda says, what's a good way to make a first YouTube video? Well, it depends on what kind of YouTube video you want to make. If you are talking about making a vlog, that's probably the easiest kind of first YouTube video to make. And for that, I would say just pick a topic that you are very passionate about and that you know that you can talk about with excitement. And then kind of peruse YouTube and find a style that you like. And so combine your original idea and passion with the style of a YouTuber that you enjoy watching and you think that you could emulate. It's not that you should copy them, but kind of following a formula that someone else is already doing and you can see an example of is a really great way for you to learn how to structure your own videos. And you'll find as you're making it, well, I like doing this, but I don't like this, or, you know, I'm editing it and this part doesn't really come off as well as this person in their video did, so maybe I shouldn't do that anymore. Treat it all as an exercise. Like in sports, you just don't walk out onto the field and start hitting home runs like in baseball. You have to do a lot of practicing and you have to probably watch other people who know what they're doing and get advice from them and try to copy some of their moves. And that's exactly what you're doing with making videos or making, you know, YouTube things. Your first video is not going to be perfect. I'm gonna link my first video in this channel over here so that you can watch it because I love this video. But it's also not the greatest video that I have ever made. It's just about learning what you can do well and what does and doesn't work on YouTube. Okay, so there are some questions. That's not as many as I wanted to get through today, but that is all the time that I have to answer questions, so that's what we're gonna go with. But I will keep answering questions next week because you guys have some great ones. Kaitlyn, you make it really difficult to caption videos because you talk so fast. I know, I'm sorry, it's a problem. I gotta get all the words out. If you guys have any more questions for me, be sure to add them into the Google form at the top of the description. And you can just leave a comment about anything pertaining to the answers I might have given or thoughts that you have, maybe your favorite musical artist, all that stuff. Just let's talk. Talk down in the description. Plus, remember to like, favorite, share, and subscribe if this video made you smile. See you guys on Thursday.